Hi, I'm Shane from Jimboomba Turf, and today we're here to talk about testing your soil. Especially at the start of spring, it's important to know what your soil needs before you start any renovations. If you don't know what your soil is lacking, you may end up wasting product by putting down the wrong thing. There are lots of simple test kits available from Bunnings, but today we're going to step things up and we're going to use the Quick Soil Test Kit from Hanna Instruments. This will give us a more accurate result. The Hanna Quick Soil Test Kit is available directly from Hanna Instruments. You can simply order online. The kit will run four tests covering the most important elements for plant growth: pH, nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. It comes with separate tubes for each test, a pipette, color result cards, and 10 sets of testing reagents. This allows you to get 10 full tests from the kit. The only other tools you will need for the test are something to get your soil samples and a jar or container for the Mpk tests and water. To get an accurate result, you want to gather soil from at least two different locations. You will need 1.5 cups of soil, so we found we needed 9 samples to get this amount. We did a comparison between our well-cared-for display plots and some uncared-for grass near our office. So we collected soil from 9 different areas at both of these locations. You want to get the soil for your test from a depth of 100 to 150 millimeters. We used a soil sampler, but you could use a simple hand shovel. Once you've pulled up the soil, mix the samples together and label them so you remember which is which. First, we did the pH test. You need to take 1/2 teaspoon of soil and add it to a test tube. For adding water, filling the tube to the lower marker. You then add the pH reagent, replacing the cap and shaking for 30 seconds. You then need to allow the tube to stand for 5 minutes. Once settled, you can compare the color of your sample to the color chart, ensuring that you have a light source behind you to accurately judge the color. We then repeated the test for the second area to compare them. For the Mpk test, you first need to follow the general extraction procedure. For each separate area you want to test, you need to combine 1.5 cups of soil with 8 cups of water. You then need to shake for 1 minute and allow to stand for 30 minutes to 24 hours, waiting until the soil has settled. We found that we needed to leave ours overnight. The clearer the extract becomes, the more accurate the test will be. Once settled, you can perform the 3 separate tests with this extract, testing for nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. For each test, you use the pipette to extract 2.5 milliliters of the clear general soil extract and add it to a clean test tube. You then add the appropriate reagent and shake for 30 seconds. Finally, you leave the tube stand for another 30 seconds before comparing the sample to the appropriate color chart. And like the pH test, we recommend recording our results immediately, as good record keeping is vital for ongoing lawn programs. We then repeated the test for the second area to compare them. When comparing the areas we tested, there was an obvious difference. The well-cared-for display plots only need a slight tweak to their program, whereas unsurprisingly, the uncared-for turf needs a lot of help. The display plots have a pH of around 5.5, which is slightly acidic. An application of garden lime will bring this up to the optimal level of around 7. The Mpk test showed that the display plots are on the high end for potassium and phosphorus, and on the low end for nitrogen. If we wanted to give this area a boost, we could use an application of a product that was 100% nitrogen, such as urea. If we felt that the plant was suffering from the high phosphorus levels, we could use a foliar application of iron. The uncared for area is clearly showing its neglect with low readings across the board. It has a pH of around 5, so we can definitely use an application of some garden lime. And the Mpk tests were all very low, so we could definitely use an application of a slow release fertilizer. Now that you know what your soil needs, you can make the appropriate amendments. For a list of actions to take, depending on your results, you can see some simple suggestions we will link to below. By regularly testing your soil, you'll have a better understanding of what your lawn really needs, and you won't waste money on things that your lawn doesn't actually need. And while there are lots of options for testing your soil, a professional kit like the Hanna Instruments Quick Soil Test Kit will always give more accurate results. See the links below to purchase your own kit. We hope these tips have been helpful for understanding what your lawn needs during this spring renovation period. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more updates, and see the Jimboomba Turf website for more tips and advice from Brisbane's leading turf supplier for over 45 years. See you next time.